Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel and welcome back to the series where you can learn how to have Swift UI-like elements in UIKit. And today we are going to talk about labels. So let's jump right into it. Okay. Now, today's topic is labels, but before we do that, let's just talk a little bit about views, because yeah, every element basic is a view. And just open up the pods file, the pods project here, and the pods folder, and the .ui folder, and you will see a lot of files there, of course. What I want you to show you today is just go ahead and select this UIView plus Swift file, and there you will see all of the so-called functions or properties that we have on this UIView extension. So if you tap on this button, you will see that we have quite a lot, and yeah, let me just go through them, and these might be missing or other more will be added as the framework .ui evolves, but yeah, I would just guide you through what these all means, and yeah, maybe just give you a few examples of the most used ones. Now, edge to safe area means that we want to edge this view to the parent view's safe area, if it's the case, or not, then just use the edge to and the view that you want to edge this view to. Set background color, self-explanatory. Set background image with the content mode, self-explanatory. Set frame, set height, set width, that is okay. We had a separate video on that. Now there comes some interesting ones. Add rotate by, and that is the degree. It rotates the view by the certain degree. As image, it creates an actual image of the UI view and every view that is in there. So you can use this to create images that you can share via the social networks. Add subviews. Now you could use add subview several times, but if you want to add more than one subviews, do a simple view, then you can use add subviews. Of course, remove subviews, that will remove all of the subviews from the view. Set corner radius, you can set the corner radius, set shadow, set border width, and this is the border color width, set border width. Yeah, that is self-explanatory. And now we have some special types of methods for border setting with the color, with the size, and here we can see that set border top. I don't know if you can really read this, but I'm reading out loud, so yeah, we can have some padding, and finally we have set scale, and then we have some animation extensions, spring animation with a duration, maybe a completion handler. Then we have some basic animations that we kind of use all the time. Add pop, add big pop, or add pop big, that's the name of the method there. Add reverse pop, and add shake for times, if you want to shake the view for a number of times, and fade in, fade out, fade to. And the last one is horizontal. Now that is the horizontal, meaning that we set the width, and for the vertical here we set the height. This is what we use for the divider. Okay, and finally set circular, that will create a circular view. Okay, I won't go into these, because go ahead and just mess on with them. It's really fun to do though, but today we are going to talk about labels. And of course you can use all of these for other elements, because yeah, UI label is a child of UI view, and UI image view is a child of UI view. So you can use all of these that I have talked about in any of those childs. So today we are talking about UI label and the specifics of UI label. Now, you have all of those that you might encounter in the UI label, but I have already set up on top the most important ones that are frequently used, and that is background, set multiline, text, font. This is text color and text, the actual text, shadow, text alignment, line break mode. Yeah, and that is basically it. Maybe is user interaction enabled, or is it enabled? You could use number of lines instead of set multiline, because basically set multiline sets the number of lines to zero, so it adjusts to the text according to its frame. So if it's a long text, it will calculate how many lines it needs. So I know we have already dived into labels the last time, but yeah, you can see we have it some text alignment and some height. And we added some debug. Now, do you remember that when you add padding and debug, it will change the return to a UI view. So after the debug, you cannot really add a text alignment. So do make sure that you are aware of that. So let me just remove this and leave the text alignment to center. And let's just talk a little bit about, let's say, the background. Okay, so UI label background and maybe set multiline. Okay, so there we go. Let's add a dot there and background color, and make sure that you actually use the one that is returning a UI label, so we can chain the other methods after we have added our background. So let's have our background color here to, let's say, red, so we can see that real nice. Okay, and let's just build and run so we can see the changes. Of course, we have a lot of labels. This is coming from the previous episode where I have introduced to you the awesome framework Layoutless. Now, how to lay out your UI views and, well, all of your UI elements without any constraints. So that was really fun to do, and yeah, I recommend using Layoutless with DocUI, and of course it's set as a dependency. So there we go, this is our hello label 0, and it has all of these background colors. Of course, if you want to change it, do ahead if your eyes ache by that red color. Next up, let me just see what we have here. So next up, we have a set multiline, and that is pretty awesome because it will basically wrap the whole text around. So it will wrap the text. So if that's just that. So set multiline, and that is just it. And now we just copy this out and paste it a lot of times, so we have a lot of text there. And let's just delete this. So command X to cut it out, because I want to paste it in just a moment. So now we will have just one line, and it will have those three dots at the end. Yeah, that's not what we want. Maybe if you want, you can set the number of lines. So let's say number of lines, and make sure you return again the UI label. Let's say 2, but I believe that will still not be enough. And yeah, you could use in some cases 2 lines, but most of the time you want to have all the text there. So yeah, I'm copying and pasting that out. Set multiline is the command R to run our project again. And oh, I need to get rid of this set height, because yeah, we are setting it as a multiline, but after that we are setting its height to 50. So now it will adjust accordingly. Of course, make sure that you are inside the DView controller and you are having all of these awesome scrolling features set. So yeah, go ahead and take a look at the whole playlist. It makes sense. Okay, what else do we have here? Let's go back to our UI label. And yeah, text alignment, you already seen that. Line break mode, you can set it to line break mode according words and so on. What I like to show, and I usually add in here, is the text and the font. And I believe we already have the text there. Let's see. Yep, this is the text. And let's add in some fonts. And I usually add that after the text. So font, And again, just return the UI label one. And let's say dot system, or not yet, let's use the bold system font of size, let's say 32. So we have a large, huge font there. And as you can see, there are a lot of methods here. So let's just use some returns here so we can have everything nice and smooth. Let's see. And we just remove some of these like so. Okay, and maybe add the text there too. Yeah, real nice. And now you can see all of the methods that you have here, and maybe set multiline too. Great. Now let's build and run and take a look at what we got here. So it's, you can really see what you have for that label. Awesome work. Yeah. One last thing, I believe we still have time for another one. So yeah, text color maybe. So if you type in text, you will see that it will have in a string. And if you type in text again, you will see that we have some color for this text. We already have the text, so let's use color. And for the text color, I will use this green to make our view more uglier, if we can at all. So let's hit Command R there. And we will see. And yeah, this is a very readable, very nice to code out too. Okay, now that is it for labels. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell, because you need to hit that notification bell to get notified of the next video. And that will be about, let me just take a look at here. Yeah, that will be about buttons and how to handle buttons the new reactive way. Okay, and as usual, I will see you in the next one.